Hello, I'm Professor Von Schmohawk, and welcome to Why You. In our lecture on the decimal number system, we explain that this is an example of positional notation. In positional notation, the column occupied by a digit determines the multiplier for that digit. Since the decimal system is base 10, each column multiplier differs by a factor of 10 from the adjacent columns. The multiplier for the rightmost digit is 1. The digits to the left are multiplied by 10, 100, and so on. The value of a decimal number is the sum of all its digits times their multipliers. For example, the value of the decimal number 1879 is 1 times 1000 plus 8 times 100 plus 7 times 10 plus 9 times 1. Using decimal notation, we can represent any integer. But decimal notation is also capable of representing fractional quantities by adding a decimal point immediately to the right of the one's digit. We can then add as many digits as we like to the right of the decimal point. Each of these column multipliers is 1/10 the size of the column to the left, continuing the pattern of multipliers. The first digit to the right of the decimal point is multiplied by 1/10. The next digit is multiplied by 1/100, and so on. Just as with integers, the value of the decimal number is the sum of all its digits times their multipliers. For example, the number 1879.25 represents 1,000 plus 800s plus 7/10s plus 9/1s plus 2/10s plus 5/100s. Using a number line, we can see how each digit adds different size divisions to the number. For example, the decimal number 3.425 represents 3 units plus 4/10 of a unit plus 2/100 of a unit plus 5/1000 of a unit. Any fraction can be converted to a decimal number by simply dividing the numerator by the denominator. We can do this using long division or with a calculator. The result of this division will be a decimal number which is equivalent to the fraction. This decimal number will either repeat or terminate. A terminating decimal number has a finite number of digits after the decimal point. A repeating decimal number has a sequence of digits after the decimal point, which repeats forever. Repeating decimals can be written with 3 dots, called an ellipsis, to indicate that the pattern repeats forever, or a bar can be placed over the digits, which repeat. For instance, we can indicate a repeating 3 by placing a bar over the 3. Likewise, a bar over a sequence of digits indicates that the sequence repeats forever. Some unit fractions, when written in decimal form, can be represented with a finite number of digits, while others cannot. For instance, the fractions 1/2, 1/4, 1/5, 1/8, and 1/10 can be written with a finite number of digits. On the other hand, the decimal equivalent of 1/3 is a decimal point followed by an infinite number of 3s. 1/6 is a decimal point followed by a 1 and then an infinite number of 6s. 1/7 is a decimal point followed by the infinitely repeating sequence 1, 4, 2, 8, 5, 7. And 1/9 is a decimal point followed by an infinite number of 1s. You may be wondering why some fractions can be represented with a finite number of digits, while others cannot. To see why, let's take a look at the fraction 1/2 on the number line. 1/2 can be represented by exactly 5/10. So 1/2 is equivalent to the decimal number 0.5. On the other hand, the fraction 1/3 is larger than 3/10, but smaller than 4/10. If we subdivide these divisions into hundredths, we see that 1/3 falls somewhere between 33/100 and 34/100. If we subdivide these divisions into thousandths, we see that 1/3 falls somewhere between 333/1000 and 334/1000. If we subdivide these divisions into 10/1000, we see that 1/3 still falls between two divisions. It is larger than 0.3333, but smaller than 0.3334. We can repeat this process indefinitely. No matter how close we zoom in, the fraction 1/3 will never fall exactly on a division. We will just keep adding threes after the decimal point forever. So, although some rational numbers, like 1/2, can be represented by a finite number of digits, others, like 1/3, cannot. We have seen that by dividing the numerator by the denominator, any fraction can be converted to an equivalent decimal number, which will either terminate or repeat. In the next lecture, we will see how to convert any terminating or repeating decimal number to a fraction.